Hey there, besties. How are we doing today? I don't know if you can tell, but I am sick. And not as in like dab dab yeet swag sick. I'm sick as in like a sinus infection situation type deal. I don't really know. Frankly, I don't really have time to go to the doctors these days. Let's just hope I don't die. That is the goal most of the time. That being said, I am eager to see Miss Amberlynn's weigh-in from the 24th. I hope that it is a good one because I'm in need of some goodness right now. So with that being said, let's do this.
Hey guys, welcome to Wednesday Weigh-In.
But if you want, can we try again? Try again. Oh, yeah.
So can we believe that this is the sixth Wednesday Weigh-In video in a row?
I'm proud of you.
Have been successful. Because I was looking through my little notebook, because this is where I keep all my notes for every week, like my weigh-ins, like how I did that week, and like the three questions that you guys asked me, and I noticed that this is the sixth one.
Good job, bestie.
I don't know. That's a record for me.
It is.
So you guys have three questions. Let's get to that first. You guys know the drill. First one is, surgery and all considered, what would you realistically like to weigh at the end of 2022? So I don't know if I am for sure getting weight loss surgery. It is just something that is currently up in the air, kind of just taking the steps towards possible surgery. Like all we have right now is an appointment in January with the surgeon. So that's literally all we have.
That's
good. Regardless,
good.
Whether I have surgery or I don't, I've already thought about this, and in a year, I would like to lose about like 150 pounds.
You can totally do that.
350. And when I say 150 pounds, I'm kind of just like rounding it. So
I love to hear that she's consulting with a weight loss doctor. Even if she doesn't, you know, end up going through with the weight loss surgery, I mean, it's good to see that she's like really taking her weight loss very seriously. My voice is starting to die. I need some water. And I love that she has like a goal set in place. I think that she totally can lose that in a year easily. She's been doing so great. I really feel like if she sticks to it and continues at this pace, we could be sitting here this time next year and she could be 150 pounds lighter.
Yeah, I think ultimately my goal, I would love to be 350 on January 1st of 2023. So that is in 13 months. I definitely think that it's doable for mm-hmm. someone my size. It is a lot of weight to lose in a year. But I feel like I'm at this stage where it's like, it needs to happen now rather than
love
later.
It.
And by the way, my heater just turned on, so that's what that noise is. Second question is there anything you fear about losing a large amount of weight? Yes, 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 yes. Honestly, my biggest fear is my lymphedema because I do have lymphedema and it is not curable. It's not something that just like goes away. There are things you could do to treat it. And one of those things is weight loss. And by treating it, you're really just like taking care of it. By me losing weight, I'm not getting rid of my lymphedema. I'm just making it a little bit smaller. And that thought scares me because it's like, while the rest of my body is about to start like shrinking even more, it's like my lymphedema is still gonna be big. And that terrifies me for like shallow reasons because it's like, I look deformed now, but I feel like if I was to lose a ton of weight and my lymphedema, like especially in my calf, like stays pretty big, like I'm gonna feel super self-conscious about that. And
yeah, I mean, I totally get that. I don't think that's like shallow. I mean, I understand that. I feel the same way. I can totally get how that would be like really discouraging. Like, you know, the rest of your body is like shrinking and there's one part of you just isn't. And like, there's nothing you can do about it. That would be really discouraging. I'm not really super familiar with lymphedema. I would hope that maybe there could be some kind of way to help that. I don't know. I really would hope that there was though, because that'd be, I'd feel bad. I'd feel really, really bad. And I could totally understand that. And that's like totally a valid fear to have.
I don't really know what to do with that. I'm trying to like push that fear away because I know that I'm actively saving my life and that's more important
True.
Than like how I look. And I
True.
Have to look at the bigger picture, you know, with weight loss, I am shrinking the lymphedema, which is actually a good thing, obviously, because that means less swelling, less pain, less chance of infection. Another fear I have, which is already something that does happen, is like realizing fat phobic people walk upon this earth way too closely. I notice that depending on what I weigh, I get treated differently, whether it be online or in person. The more I weigh, the less smiles I get in public or the less respect I get in public, versus when I start to lose weight, I notice people starting to smile more at me, being more a little bit more friendly. And to me, that's frustrating. So it's like, let's just say in this wild, wild land we have here, I'm like in the 200s and people start treating me drastically better. Like that scares me because it's just like, damn, you couldn't have treated me with the same respect just because like I weighed higher than I do now. Like it just, I don't know, I don't like the thought.
So here's my thing. Something in my gut tells me maybe that might not have happened, but I don't know. But I mean, I would agree that that is really awful to treat somebody differently just because of their size. Like being concerned about somebody is one thing, but like being disrespectful, like that's gross. And not lit at all. Not at all.
Do not like the thought, but it does happen and that's like reality. A lot of people share stories of like how they get treated so much differently once they've lost a ton of weight. And I just think that's so wrong. And it truly just goes to show, it's like a real life experiment of, is fat shaming real? Because yes, it really is. So there are like a few more little things that I do fear, but another one I really, really fear is like, what if I'm spending all of this time focusing on weight loss, which has been fun at times. It's been amazing to see my accomplishments, but it's also been very hard at other times. I have literally cried my eyes out because I wanted to binge so bad and I just wouldn't allow myself. Like,
that's awesome.
All those hard moments and like those moments of choosing broccoli over hot Cheetos. It's like, was it all worth it? Is it all gonna be worth it? The best way I can describe that is like, I'm losing weight for health reasons, but what if my future, there is something wrong with me, like health related, that my weight had nothing to do with? Like, does that make sense what I'm trying to say?
That totally makes sense. But I guess the way to think of that is there's nothing you can do to prevent those things. But losing weight, regardless, is going to be good for your health one way or another. Unfortunately, there are just some things. Bodies are weird. Sometimes things are going to happen to you that just make no sense, that have nothing to do with your weight, that have nothing to do with your lifestyle. Sometimes you just have weird things happen. Baby girl, that's life. Sometimes that just happens, but that should not hold you back from choosing broccoli over hot Cheetos. Because even if you do have these like health issues, of course it's gonna be worth it, because regardless, you're still adding years onto your life. You're still gonna be able to go hiking with your girlfriend. Little things. Remember, singing in the shower, bestie.
Hard work doesn't pay off. That is what I'm trying to say. That is terrifying, but I do not want to look at it like that. But these are just like true normal fears that I have in the back of my mind. But I still feel like these fears are not strong enough to prevent me from losing weight.
Good.
Because the fear of me dying prematurely, now that's the strong fear. That's the fear that's in the forefront of my brain. So the last question is, will you ever actually try to get healthy, or will it always be for the views? This question frustrates me for several reasons, because it's like, when I was gaining weight, people thought it was for the views. And now, according to this person, me losing weight is for the views. I have never gained weight or lost weight for the views or for YouTube. Like, me gaining weight happened to just be documented online, which happened to get me the most views, which is sad. Like, I feel like I can go down like a whole tangent when it comes to this topic. So many people have been saying like, I'm super boring lately. And I noticed that people find me the most boring when I'm actually being like successful, when there's no like trolling or there's no like mukbangs on my channel. And the reason why I know this is because if you go to my channel and you go to the most popular videos, it's all of me eating, or just like super troll train wreck videos. That's what entertains people the most. So it's like, it's sad that people call me boring now, but on the same, it's kind of like a compliment.
Here's my thing. If she's losing weight just for views, I'm okay with that. Like, I'll take that. At this point, if she really genuinely is losing weight and it's only to get views, okay, sure. Okay, Jen, I'll take that. I will give you those views because I just want her to lose weight. I'm okay with her using it for views. Okay, fine. I want to say, though, that she really is genuinely doing this for herself. Maybe the Becky breakup really did sister snap something in her brain, because it seems like, for the most part, she really is doing a lot better, and I love that. I don't know if she necessarily gained weight for views. I would say, like she, that she did mukbangs for views, because she knows that, you know, gets her views. So the thing that she was doing indirectly caused weight gain. So she wasn't, like, technically gaining weight. Weight for views, but like what she was doing for views caused her to gain weight. That's my philosophy behind it.
I feel like I'm rambling, but I'm trying to say is, me losing weight is not for the views. If I wanted views and that was my goal, was to get as many views as I could, weight loss videos would not be it. That's not the answer. Mukbangs are the answer. Troll videos are the answer. But doing these What I Ate Today videos, these weigh-in videos, it's not for views. It's just me sharing my journey. Okay, so now it is time for the weigh-in.
Let's
so last
see, girl.
Wednesday, which was November 17th, I weighed in at 498.6. So normally I would sit here and tell you guys like what I weighed every single day, but I did not do daily weigh-ins. It's mainly because I was low-key kind of off track on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. And I personally did not want to step on the scale and see the damage that I did, so I just didn't. Plus, I noticed a lot of people saying, don't weigh yourself daily. We don't care about the daily weigh-ins. We just want to know how much you lost in a week.
Mm-hmm.
I'm hearing you guys. I'm listening to you guys. So I'm definitely going to stop telling you guys, like, if I do end up weighing daily, like, next week, I'm not going to sit here and tell you guys my weight every single day, because I hear you guys loud and clear. Sometimes all the numbers get super confusing, so I totally understand. So besides those 3 days where I was kind of off track, I had a pretty decent week.
That's
so
good.
I weighed in today on November 24th at
a live weigh-in. Let's see. Hey, there you go, bestie. Love it. Good job. Awesome.
93.4.
Perfect. Good job.
So I did decide to film it for you guys. I figured, what the heck? This is a super easy clip. Let's just set my camera up.
Yeah.
Set my scale up.
Where I like seeing the live
weigh-in. I know it has been requested, so I figured, why not? So that means this week I am down 5.2 pounds.
That's good.
Overall, I am down 79, which is only 1 pound away from 80.
That's awesome.
And 21 pounds away from losing 100. I think that is pretty fantastic.
It is so fantastic. Absolutely.
Is holiday week. Tomorrow is Thanksgiving, and I will be spending it by myself alone. So I don't have like a big Thanksgiving dinner to worry about or anything like that. But my goal still stays the same. I really just want to every day make sure I am doing my exercises, moving more, paying attention to what I'm eating, counting calories. And every week, I just want to be down more weight. I'm just really excited to hit that 100-pound mark. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.
All right, besties, thank you so much for watching today. What did you guys think of today's video? I need more water. Right. Oh, geez. I'm glad to see that she's really sticking to her weight loss journey. That is wonderful. I'm super proud of her. That's great. 5 pounds is better than 0 pounds. I'll take it. I hope that she doesn't, you know, have a moment on Thanksgiving and like lose track of her goal. Like, cause spending it alone, that's kind of sad. So it could be a good thing or it could be a bad thing. I don't know if that'll trigger her like having to be alone. I hope it doesn't. And I'm sorry. All right, besties. Well, thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Speaking of subscribe, I gotta give an extra special a shout out to my beloved channel members: Jasmine Lavon, Seabell, Senya, Sophie Watson, Blukey, April, Katie Butler, Elizabeth W, Chloe D, Lilith 77, Panda, Fonda Silva, Mystic Magic, Luna Meowers, Joey, Pokey 2, Tori Gallagher, A Real Bear, Kristen Arby, Elizabeth Richardson, Roly Poly Toad, Feline Swartzentraub, Desiree Wild, Saber Sword Song, Nikki Fitness, Little B, Phineas the Hedgehog, Mrs. Lugo, and last but not least, Angelina Rafut. Thank you all so much for grandma. Just a little bit extra support. I love you. I appreciate you. You guys are real ones. I love you a whole lot. And question of the day, what is your favorite Thanksgiving food, and did you eat that on Thanksgiving? I'm a stuffing kind of queen for sure. I love me some stuffing, and I did indeed eat lots of stuffing on Thanksgiving, as I should. Thank you for spending precious minutes of your beautiful life with me and my cat. We both adore you, we both appreciate you, and you are so important, you are so cherished. Don't ever think for a second your life does not have meaning, because if I found out one of you besties were gone, I am like not even kidding, I'd be devastated. I'd be fully devastated. So I need you to stay here for me, because I love you and I need you, and you're so important, and you probably don't even know like your purpose yet, and it's gonna blow your mind when you're like, wow, I'm capable of this amazing thing, bestie. And I can't wait to see it. I can't wait to see all my presidents and CEOs and doctors and surgeons and professors. Like all of you are so cool. Like, you're definitely gonna do some cool stuff. Anyway, okay, I love you. Goodbye.